Oh, I haven't seen you in forever, dude. What are you doing here? I saw a fire exploding in your warehouse. Your items are at serious risk, but I can fix it for a price. Bouncer, I saw you starting the fire. You can fix everything for free. You know what, dude? The very first bouncer I ever hired was because of you and the fact that you are a complete and utter jackwagon. So how about you have a chat with the incredibly large individual behind me, and I hope you end up in the hospital.
Performing the duties of his office.
Of Digby C. Caesar.
No.
Well, hey, everybody. Thanks for stopping by. I am Digby, and today we are back in Dealer's Life 2, where... I'm trying to remember what we did at the end of last week. Okay, the poster was fine. Let's just real quick check the inventory. Did I pick something up, maybe? Okay, you know what? That's worth 6.8. I paid 5.8. I can fix that up. So if I didn't, I'm actually going to this time. Okay, full main and change. That's also fixable. That's getting examined. I don't know why. 3.5 million. 10.2 million, but I can't do anything with it. And that's authenticated. You're 6.5. We already knew that. You're 1.3 million. Yeah, we've got a lot of good inventory. That's the thing we're actually going to go sell. So yeah, I think we're going to fix this thing up. Yes, get it done. And if we can... What was the other big ticket item I had that I could fix? Was it the snow globe? Yeah, you know what? Let's just chuck some love on the snow globe as well. Okay, I'm happy with that. Let's go to auction. I do remember that we got, I think, 30 million something for this last time. Like 30,500,000 maybe. So, fingers crossed we get at least close to that number. Ah, come on, public. Start me off on a high note, will ya? Okay, I'm gonna call that one significant improvement. Thank you, Tardancia Lang, for paying 41 million bucks for that. And now suddenly I feel a lot better about my chances. Okay, I also wanted to look into getting more skills. I can afford one of these right now. I'm kind of close to master level. What do we got? I can never remember what these things do. Okay. Alright, I don't want to sell fake items that easily. That's what I want. I want to be able to friggin' inspect things and tell what's a fake and what isn't. So yes, I will take the competence. Oh my god, the numbers are getting ridiculous. Oh, they got the Halloween thing going on. Okay, we got the witch's hat and a couple of spiders. I wonder if they decorated the shop. Yep, we got a candy jar with some candy in it over here, and what looks like a little pumpkin banner. Okay, sorry, Mr. Quibble, I was busy looking at the decorations. Congratulations, you won the amateur restoration lottery. Some items will be restored by free of a group of amateur restorers. Will they do a good job? They probably will if my restorer helps. You... It's gonna be one of those weeks, is it? Okay. Morning, they call me Rosary Agathon. You know I love the name Rosary. I got a little treasure, I bet you love it. It looks like a little silver coin. Under $1 million, you know what, darling? Nope. Hi, my name's Kitty Pewterschmidt. I saw that piece over there, I've got cash. Well, it must take you forever to fill out your checks. Alright, what do you got? You want my medieval jewelry box that they just freaking broke and now is worth less than I paid for it. The worst thing is I just spent time fixing that friggin' Ready Player One poster up, and then they turned around and screwed it up. Alright, talk to me. No, you're gonna have to go a little ways, because I want to at least break even on this stuff. So how do you feel about 1.4 million? I mean, I'd like to make a little tiny bit of profit. What if you say 1.26 million? Oh, God. Am I gonna have to eat it? Tell you what, 1,320,000 bucks. That's not gonna be any profit, hardly at all, for me, but... I'm desperate. Okay, we made a whole 10,000 bucks on it. Technically, we made 9. God. Morning, they call me Julian Yee. I found a little treasure while I was checking the kitchen. What do you think? I think it's worth less than $1 million, is what I think. Hi, my name's Nurey Moroney. I kept a little treasure in my pockets for ages. You want to buy a... I don't know, I got kind of a soft spot for the friggin' Dicky Bird thing. Oh, and I can fix it up, too, because it's in terrible shape. It's actually worth 1.4 million, give it to... You know what? I'm going for it. Yes, please. My price? 1 million even. How do you feel about that? That do anything for you? 1.5 million. Ah. Now we're kind of in that area where I can, like, add love to it and maybe make a little bit. I tell you what, I'm going to try 1,250,000 and see if you'll bite. 1,420,000, you're getting closer. How do you feel about 1,350,000? Please tell me you'll take 1,300,000. You know what? 1,400,000, done. Oh, it's already keyed into the thing down here. Yes, I'll take it. Hi, my name is Vincent Gygax. I borrowed a unique piece. I need to make some money. Hammer time! Be nice now. It's been a while since I got to play that joke. Okay, what do we got? 2,800,000, not a fake. Sounds good to me, yes. 3,200,000 does not sound good to me, unfortunately. How about 2,250,000? You say 2,250,000, I say 2,900,000. Well, what you say doesn't really matter. It's what I say that counts. So how do you feel about... I'll go a little bit under market, maybe. See what happens. Hi, you can call me Eric Hernandez. I got a unique piece. I need to make some money. It's not that unique. I've actually got one in my inventory at the moment. However, it is worth a ton of money, so yes, please. Experts are completely bloody useless. Yeah, let's talk. Can I get it for slightly below market? Will you please, please, please let me have it for 4 million bucks? That's great, thank you. That's about what I thought you were gonna do. Hello, my name is John June Kimmel. Okay, any relation to Jimmy Kimmel? I was cleaning up the crime scene when I found something that will surely be worth a lot of money. Somehow I doubt it, and I had one fairly recently, too. Nope, not worth a lot of money. Hate to break your heart, but such is life. Morning, my name's Emir Hutton. I found a little treasure while I was checking my handbag. You want to buy it for sure? I wouldn't hold my breath on that, my friend. Yeah, sorry, I'm going to have to pass on that one. Hi, my name's Astrid McCoy, Star Trek joke. I want to give you a little unique piece. I want to sell it. Alright, it's a different kind of armor. Renaissance armor, belonged to Oscar Wilde. It's worth 2 million bucks. It's worth 2,050,000 bucks. Oh, you are way off, darling. I am so sorry to be you, but you're going to get, well, pretty much offered $2 million, and you're going to take it, or you're going to vacate my shop and never darken my door again. Okay, she does want to be a repeat customer. Perfect. Hey, what's up? They call me Lester Bing. I was cleaning up the attic when I found a little treasure here. Take a look. It looks like it's not worth anything. No idea. The expert won't tell me either. Guess a price. Fine. 50 grand. No, that's not 50 grand, Digby. That's 500,000. You see? Okay, so it's worth 1,000,000 at least. I tell you what, buddy. I'll go to 1,000,000 for you. I'm willing to gamble that much on it. Alright, you thought you could accept it. Good. Good boy. Thank you. So there, they call me Leonardo Basach. I just obtained a unique piece of one. Oh, we haven't had dirty underwear in forever. Yes, please. How much? $500,000. Guess what? Laundromat's across the street. See ya. Okay, item's been redeemed. I got $1,000,000 for that. That's good, because I lost some money. Okay, the ancient armor is authentic. It's worth $100,000. Yeah, we're going to be doing some inventory stuff today. You know, end of the day, they knocked some money off of that, but I only paid 3 and it's worth 10 still. Okay, my Bachokopo, whatever it is, you're gonna get cleaned up here eventually. That, I have no idea what is... Oh, that's a pawn. I was gonna say, I have no idea what I was thinking, but there you go. Okay, is there any of the stuff we can do anything to? That's good, that's very good, that's very good. Okay, so the $1,000,000 chair is probably the only thing left we can fix up once these guys get done, and damn well, they'll be done tomorrow. Might as well go back to work, I guess. Hello, they call me Astrid Killis. I found a little treasure while I was checking the attic. Isn't it awesome? It's not terrible. Ah, it's really close to being terrible, though. No, I tell you what, let's see what you think about 900 grand. I know I'm going to have to be in the neighborhood of market for a while. Alright, you think you can accept it? Good. So I could use a little extra inventory. Hi, you can call me Jose Maradona. Okay. I'm here with a unique piece, you can't miss it. It's a Halo helmet, and it's a fake. A $12,600,000 fake. Dude, you should be absolutely ashamed of yourself. Hi, my name's Jimmy Streisand. I was wandering around and I saw that gem over there. Would you sell it to me? Ooh, I see the little diamond. Oh, you want the mall? Yes, you can have that. Tell me you're gonna pay me way more than it's worth. 3,000,001? I'll tell you what, I'm gonna try and get 3,500,000 out of you, because I lost a little money on those idiot restorer people. And I'd like to get some of it back. Morning, you can call me Heidi Cooper. I won something, now you showered me with money. It's the FTL ship. Faster than sound spaceship, belonged to Mark Hamill, so Star Wars coming back strong. 1,000,004, it's actually worth 1,000,016. Alright, let's talk. Wow, you're actually somewhere reasonable. How do you feel about 900,000? Whoops. I have got to be careful not to do that. Okay, you'll take that. That's good. Nice when your guys are malleable. Hi, you can call me Yevgeny Schroeder. I've got something here. You'll bet you love it. Actually said I've got here something, but my brain wouldn't let me go there grammatically. Okay, what do we got? Dawn of Brawl, 2,000,002. 2,000,003, give or take. All right, let's talk. How about 2 million? Again, I know I'm stuck right in the neighborhood of market, so I'm not going to be too argumentative.
Oh, come on, please.
Unlike you jackoffs, who just are not very grateful today. Yeah. Hello there, I'm Zhen Zhen Moore. I'd love to buy that piece over there. Give it to me or I'll be very sad. Well, you do have the right size stack. Okay, you want my $4 million armor. That looks like way more than $4 million. Oh, apparently she doesn't think it is, though. No. That's gonna pretty much go for 4-5, or you're just gonna go full stop. Hello, you can call me Nana Lichter. Oh, Nana Visitor's a Star Trek one. I've got a little treasure that should be worth a lot of money. Pretty sure I just got offered a fake one of these not too long ago. This one at least appears to be real. We think. Okay, 3,000,008. Let's talk. I'll go to 3,000,005. That's not a 3, Digby, for God's sakes. I know the mic stand's in the way, but Christ's sakes, you should be able to type at least halfway decently blind. Alright, 3,000,005 is mine. Hi, I'm Matthew Toye. I really need to buy that piece over there. You should consider selling it to me. Well, you have a briefcase full of cash and some dirty laundry. I was going to say, you absolutely must want my Nobody Sky poster. I say let's talk. You want to know what I think it costs? I think it costs... I'm going to start really crazy. We're just going to go for 15 million right off the bat. You're thinking market. I tell you what, if you're willing to come up a little bit over that, I'm willing to part with it. How do you feel about that? You feel like that's great. Perfect. $7 million profit. Thank you. Morning, name's James Sue. I want that item, I really want it. Yo, I'll tell you what I want, what I really, really want. Alright, well, if you don't like the Spice Girls, you can blame James Sue for that, not me. Okay, what do you want? You want my Dawn of Brawl? I paid $2 million, it's worth $2,000,003. That looks like a $3 million stack, so you know what? Yours, done. I'm not even gonna think about that one for more than a second. Hello, you can call me Ursula Sarah. I want that gem over there, I've got cash. You don't have as much as the last guy, which is a complete shame. Okay, you want the knife that I thought I could get at least a million for. Wow, you guys are really generous today. Thank you, darling. Mwah. Okay, my new Milan Cathedral, no idea. That thing's worth 7,900,000. Holy crap. Okay, well, you guys are doing really good work in here. How about you fix up my dirty old chicken? And then, okay, that's garbage. What else did we buy today? We got a $3 million Halo helmet. That's worth nothing. Chair's still worth nothing. That's not worth that much. No, I don't know why I keep looking at the damn pawn. I can't do anything with it. Oh, you know what? Fix up my Waiting Player 2 poster. Sounds good to me. Oh, we got an auction too. We can go buy some stuff. I don't know why I'm getting excited. This never ever works. In fact, it all just looks like garbage. You know what? We're going to skip it this week. To hell with it. Let's just go back to work. Hi, my name is Michelle Jesden. I really want... Oh. Always fun trying to record in a rainstorm. Okay, hi, my name is Michelle Jesden. I really need to buy that item. Give it to me. I'm not going to give it to you, but you're in the $3 million stack range, so I'm happy to sell it to you. To me, you know what? Welcome to No Arguments Day. Morning, they call me Adrian Bedore. I want that piece over there. Give it to me, I'll be very sad. Your eyes are absolutely creeping me out. But your stack is actually making me happy. So, it's 3,000,005. It's worth 3,000,008. I'm going to come in at 4,000,005 just to start. Hopefully it'll do something for you. No, it doesn't. How about 4,250? When I said no argument day, I meant on you guys' side, not mine. Alright, that works for me. I'll take almost 1,000,000. Hello there, they call me Deanna Schofield. I've been told to bring you a unique piece. What do you think? I think it looks like a little stone statue. It's worth 2,000,000 bucks. Almost. Yeah, we can talk. Nope, that's not gonna happen. I'll go 1,000,008. I'm gonna try and stay a little bit below market on these things and see. 1,980, you're not moving from it. Well, you may not be moving from there, but you are moving from here. Hey, what's up? You call me Les Hoffman. I've been told to bring you something. Should I say any more? I already got one of these, dude. What's it worth? 3,000,006. I don't know what the other one was worth, but you know what? Apparently, I'm now selling faster than light souvenirs. Okay, 3,000,004. 3,000,250. That's exactly not how to write that, Digby. $3,250,000. What do you think? Done. Cool. Thank you. Morning. They call me Obi-Wan Webb. Yeah, Star Wars is really fighting back today. Here's a little treasure. Need to make some money. Yada, yada, yada. I can't remember what poster it is. It's the Wycom one. Long to Mark. You know what? Star Wars is actually winning today. All right. 3,000,003. I could probably get it for 3. Maybe. If I'm lucky. You don't know. Well, sucks to be you, dude. I'm satisfied. Hi, they call me Amy Burkle. I borrowed a little treasure. Could be yours at the right price. I swear to God, I got one of these in my inventory as well. I do have one of these in my inventory. What'd you got? Was there like a yard sale or something I missed? Okay, let's talk. Well, you know what? 8,000,006 isn't the right price, but if it's worth that much, 8,000,000 is definitely something you should consider. Hooray! Hello, you can call me Shirley Wheaton. Okay, Will Wheaton. Star Trek is fighting back slightly. Got a unique piece. It'll surely be worth a lot of money. It's not that unique. I've seen one in this episode. It's not worth a lot of money either, so bye. Hello there, you can call me Marion Pacino. All right. I was cleaning up my wardrobe when I found a unique piece. Could this tickle your interest? Ancient decorated books always tickle my interest. Unfortunately, they have to now be worth $1,000,000 or they don't. Hey, what's up? Name's Rosary Wright. Second one we've had in this episode. Thinking about buying that gem over there? Give it to me or I'll be very sad. Well, I'm thinking about your gem right there. Ancient armor, I paid 4. It's worth 4,000,002. You're offering me under 4,000,000. 4,000,005 or go to hell. That's great, thank you. May the rest of the day treat you well. Alright, nothing exciting in the paper. I guess we're going back to work for day 4. Hello there, you call me Courtney Tucker. I won something, it'll fit wonderfully in your shop. I don't think it's going to be worth that much. Oh, I take it back, it is. No idea if it's real or not, but you know what? We'll take a flyer on it. I know I'm going to have to stay close to market, so... 3,000,005, maybe? You're surely not going to argue with that. That's what I thought. Of course you're not going to argue with that. Hi, you can call me Tifa Danis. I saw that piece over there. I won't leave it here. Okay. Again, like the size of your pile there, darling. I paid 3, worth 3.5, 3,000,007. I said it was no argument day, so yeah, thanks. Morning, you can call me Zahui Perry. I want to buy that gem over there. I bet you want to sell it to me. Ooh, you bet correctly, sir. That's the Milan Cathedral. I paid 2,000,009. He's got a briefcase full of freaking money. So surely he's going to offer me a stupid amount, yes? How about 6? Is that stupid enough? Oh my god, I should have started at 7. Yeah, look at me complaining about just making a $3 million profit. Oh, wow. Okay, this thing looks cool. Hi, I'm Gunther Bottom. I just obtained a little treasure. You want to buy it for sure? Well, it's definitely piqued my interest. It's a Mickey Ronti spaceship. Belonged to Jesus. It's worth $9 million. It's in bad shape, so I can fix it up. Oh, God, please don't be a fake, and please don't be a cheapskate. I'm going to come in at 8, and hope like hell he's dumb enough to let me have it. Okay, either he's the biggest idiot that ever walked, or it's a complete fake. Morning, they call me Zalia Shabatsky. I was cleaning up the garage, and I found a little treasure. You can't miss it. Okay. Ancient decorated vase, belonged to Carl Lewis. It's kind of cool. I've never seen one before. Oh, crap. Do I really want this piece of junk? No, because if I start buying junk now, you guys are just going to bring me nothing but junk. So no, not going to do it. Hi, name's Joey McElroy. I got a little treasure. Take a look and tell me you want it. There is no way in hell this thing's worth $1 million. That's what I thought. I'm never taking another toaster again. Go away. Hey, what's up? They call me Gianna Schulte. I got something. It will surely be worth a lot of money. It's possible, I suppose. Nope. Absolutely wrong. Not worth anything. Oh, I love you people when you show up. Morning, name's Barbara Siddig. I was wandering around and I saw that gem over there. You have to sell it to me. It's got to be the most expensive thing in the store. Tell you what, make me an offer, dear. Yeah, that's going to happen every time. Hi, what's up? I'm Don Hernandez. I really need to buy that gem over there. Give it to me. Weirdly enough, way back in the day, the Houston Astros wore uniforms with like that color, and every time I see this shirt, I think it's an Astros player, and it didn't hurt that the dude's wearing a hat. Okay, you want my FTL ship? I paid 3.2, it's worth 3.6. You're thinking 3.3. Tell you what, 3.5 million. That's actually less than market. Yeah, I was gonna say, I offer you less than market, you better jump on it, dude, because it doesn't happen very often. Alright, Digby, you done choking now? Good morning, name's Elise Radnor. I can hear a little treasure fit wonderfully in your shop. I actually had one not too long ago. Old gold knife, connected to sword fighting era, belonged to Abraham Lincoln's, worth $4 million. Worth $4.5 million, according to the expert. Oh, we're never going to agree on $5.8 million. We're going to agree on $4,250,000, or we're going to agree that you're just a terrible person and you need to go away. Morning, I'm Philomena Babakan. I just obtained a unique piece. I need a pawn loan. It's a statue of David. It can't be worth much. There's another shop down the road, darling. He likes cheap stuff. You might have better luck there. Okay, my waiting player 2 poster is now $6,000,009. I thought I had 2 things getting restored, did I not? Oh, that's gonna take way longer than I thought it was gonna take. Okay, well, we got a couple of good items in here at least, so... Oh yeah, that's... I paid 47, that's worth $1 million. I love that. Okay. 116, 8, can't fix it. 3,600,000 and I can. So yeah, we'll fix that up. We'll go back to work. Oh, I haven't seen you in forever, dude. What are you doing here? I saw a fighter exploding in your warehouse. Your items are at serious risk, but I can fix it for a price. Bouncer, I saw you starting the fire. You can fix everything for free. You know what, dude? The very first bouncer I ever hired was because of you and the fact that you were a complete and utter jackwagon. So how about you have a chat with the incredibly large individual behind me, and I hope you end up in the hospital. Nothing happens. Okay, so nothing happened to my stuff. Hopefully something terrible happened to him. Hello there, you can call me Jenny Harris. I inherited a unique piece. You want to buy it for sure? It's a stone throne. Ancient armchair, belonged to Leonardo da Vinci. Well, you're in the right price. You're over $1 million. Uh-oh. Unfortunately, darling, it's a fake. Hello there, they call me Smith Killick. I'm here with something very interesting, isn't it? Not that interesting. I had one not too long ago. Nah, definitely not very interesting. Sorry, dude. Hi, I'm George Guilfoyle. I want to buy that item. I got big cash for you. Okay, you've got some cash for me. Ah, please make me a ludicrous offer. How much would I say? I don't know, $1.5 million? I mean, I can make you a ludicrous offer just as well. Holy crap, he took it. All right, thank you, dude. Oh, hold on 1 second. All right, well, while I was off camera choking to death, I happened to notice how this young lady over here was dressed, and, darling, I don't know who chose those shoes for you, but they were absolutely wrong. Okay, hello there, name's Fritz May. I kept something in the kitchen for ages. I bet you love it. I most certainly do not. Hello there, they call me Margaret. Would that be Margaret or Marjorie? I'm gonna go with Marjorie or Marjorie just for fun. Okay, Marjorie Bays. Sorry, I'd lost track of where I was in the sentence. Clean up the kitchen. I found something. Should I say any more? You could explain how you got a Lamborghini into your kitchen. Ah, it's 8:20, but it's bad. You know what? Even if I fix it up, it's only worth $1 million. Just take it and drive away, thanks. Hi, I'm Maria Weeb. I want to buy that piece over there. You should consider selling it to me. Well, you've definitely got my attention. Okay, you want my $8 million cathedral. You're not thinking anywhere near $8 million bucks, though. Oh, wait a minute. Hold up, hold that thought. Hold up. Before I offer you any money whatsoever... Okay, that's 6, that's 3, that's 9... Is this my biggest big-ticket item? Okay, that's 8. Yeah, that's my super big-ticket item. I'm not selling that thing to you, darling. That's gotta go to the auction. Sorry. Hello there, name's Christina Tam. Tam's actually a Firefly reference, or Serenity if you preferred the movie. I was cleaning up the garage when I found something. What do you think? I think your eyebrows are really weird. Okay, collectible katana, it's worth $50. I think you really shouldn't have brought that here. Hi, name's Scott Cartel. I almost said Cartel just then, I don't know why. Borrowed a little treasure, I want to get rid of it. It's a sacrificial altar, yada yada yada, it's worth $500,000. No. Hey, what's up? You can call me Zoe LaForge. Yay, Star Trek! I want a unique piece, what do you think? I think it's gonna be a stretch to say that's worth $1 million. And wow, was I right. Sorry, darling. Okay, is there any- oh, inventory. Yes, that's what we were doing. We were locking this up because we don't want anybody to try and buy it. I want to take it to the auction where everybody is generous and nobody is stupid. Hi, my name's Shirley Cross. I kept something in the house for ages here. Have a look. Is that a- friggin', it is. It's bagpipes. Renaissance bagpipe, produced in 1528, connected to the Mughal Empire. It's mythic, it's bad. I've never had one, and you know what? It's freaking bagpipes. My friggin' Scottish ancestors would never forgive me for not at least trying to get these. However, they were cheap bastards, and they would definitely forgive me for not playing $1,000,002 for a $920,000 item. $850, darling, or you know what you can do with your bagpipes. Hello there, they call me Darren Bauman. I just fell in love with that item. I've got cash. Well, hopefully you got more than the last lady. Paid $1,000,000 for it. Dude, make me an offer that's over $1,000,000. $1,250,000. You think it's a good deal? You took it? Hello, they call me Giuseppe Walter. I want to give you something very interesting, isn't it? I've had these before. Okay, yeah, it's the Dragon Ball thing. That's worth $910. It's actually worth $920. Oh, hold up. What kind of shape is this thing in? It's in good shape. You know what? No. A friggin' rule is a rule. Nothing under $1,000,000. Go away. Hey, what's up? Name's Seda Preston. I've been told to bring you a unique piece. Should I say any more? I wouldn't even bother to say that much, darling. Hi, you can call me Linda Brightaxe. I inherited a little treasure. You'll surely like it. Well, it's $1,000,002, so yeah, he's kinda got my attention. My price? $1,000,000 even. And you're gonna hate it, you're gonna ask me for like $1,000,000. Well, actually, you know what? Your price is fairly reasonable. I'll take it. Morning, my name is Suzanne Beck. I'd like to purchase that item. I've got big cash for you. You do indeed have big cash for me. Okay, you want my $8 million Gundam. Oh no, you're thinking what I paid for it. You're not thinking about what it's worth, because that thing is worth at least $8 million. That's more like it, see? I knew one of us was thinking straight. Hey, what's up? My name's Rick Yilmaz. I just obtained a little treasure to fit wonderfully in your shop. It's that weird ghost thing. Yeah, the ghost in the shell. Well, $4,000,002. Alright, $4,000,001. It did belong to Pele, so... I'm gonna try and get it for 3.5. I don't think the guy's gonna sell it to me for that, but... Okay, he wants to sell it at market. You know what? I'm not gonna get much lower than that anyway, so yes, I'll take it. Thank you very much. Okay, I now own a Toon sidecar. Is that the thing I kept looking at? No idea what the Bokeo is worth. No idea what the medieval bed is worth. We do have a storage auction. Might as well do that before we do the inventory stuff. Okay, what do we got today?
You can't touch this.
Okay, no estimate on that. We got a book. I do like books. No estimate on any of this crap. Starting price is $2 million though, so there's got to be at least something decent in here. I'm thinking what? I'll go up to maybe 4.5, possibly 5. Might go a little higher maybe if I'm feeling frisky. I don't know, we'll see. Okay, that was kind of in between frisky and risky, but you know what? $5,000,007 isn't terrible. Hopefully the estimates will tell us that this stuff is worth more than I paid. Okay, paid $4 million, no idea. Ah, oh, crap. Nope, I overpaid. Damn it. You know what? We might make it back on the hammer at least. Oh, that's the crappy book I got in the auction. That was there another book there that I didn't see? Okay, well, you know what? I got a bunch of garbage I can't do anything with. Ooh, you know what? Actually, we can make our money back on this by getting a restorer on it. So, yes, do that, please. I can fix the bed up. There's really no point. I can fix that up. That's worth more money. Please, people, come in and buy this garbage and get it out of my store. Hey, what's up? Name's Melanie Miller. I'd love to buy that item I've been looking for ages. Okay, it's the book I actually did pay money for. How do you feel about 1,000,005? That gonna tickle your pickle? Sucks to be you. Oh, no. Alright, it did something else with your pickle. I don't care. You paid 1,000,005 for it, so I'm happy. Hi, you can call me Marty Helson. I'm thinking about buying that piece over there I've been looking for ages. You've come to the right place, Marty. Okay, I paid 4,700. It's worth 6,900. 8,000,000 is the price. Oh, tell me you'll go up a little bit. I mean, 9,000,000 on a thing I paid around 5 for would be brilliant. Oh, good. I'm glad you could accept my offer. Hello there. They call me Burke Flyenberg. I saw that piece over there. I'll let you think about it. Don't have to think, dude. All yours. Oh, it's one of the garbage ones, too. So, yep, make me an offer. 4,800. Done. I'm just going to cut my losses on that crap. Hi, my name's Isolde Abernathy. I'd love to buy that gem over there. I've been looking for ages. I almost did the Tristan and Isolde joke again, but I'm not sure anybody got it. It's been like 3 or 4 episodes when I did it last time, so yeah, trust me, it's a opera joke. Just leave it at that. Okay, let's see. Ancient armor. I paid 47. It's worth about 1,000,000. You know what? On a $50,000 item, darling, sold. That's about the most profit per investment I've ever made in my life. Hey, what's up? Jonathan Kurt. I want to buy that piece over there. Will you sell it to me? Okay, you want the bed. I paid $3,700,000. You're thinking for me? Okay. Welcome back to No Arguments Night. Hey, what's up? My name's Judith Polat. Found a unique piece. Should I say any more? It's not that unique. I had one not too long ago, but I tell you what, they are worth a fair bit of money. Sure. My price? I mean, look at it. It's terrible. How about 800,000 bucks? You're thinking 1,000,005? Oh, guess what I'm thinking about? Bye-bye! Hi, I'm Bruce Abruzzi. I found something while I was checking my pockets. Take a look. Tell me you want it. Oh, I've seen this one before. It's the Buddhist temple one. Okay, you know what? It's not worth 1,000,000 bucks either, dude. So I guess the week is just going to end on a bit of a downer. Well, the week might ended on a downer, but hopefully the auction will perk things back up. And what do we got going on in here? Just make sure I'm not missing anything. Yeah, apart from that crap I bought at that last auction, everything else in here is looking pretty good. So I'm thinking... Oh, hold up. Alright, well apparently that's a screw-up that I can't fix, and it also means that I didn't get to sell anything at the auction last week, so... Yeah, I'm thinking if this is where we're going to have to end the video, this might as well be where the next one starts. And I'll just have to hope that in the next one, I'm a little bit more competent. But yeah, as always, I've been Digby. Thank you guys for stopping by. I really hope you guys enjoyed this episode of Dealer's Life 2. And yeah, I hope to see you for the next one.